Thank you, Madam Toastmaster, fellow members, our guest. In 1555, two bishops from the Church of England were burned at the stake by Queen Mary because they refused to agree with Roman Catholic Church doctrine. And this was right after the Queen Mary wanted to put England back into the Roman Catholic Church. These two bishops were named Nicholas Ridley and Hugh Latimer. And right before Hugh Latimer died, he looked to his friend to give him an encouraging words, and he said, "Be of good comfort, Mr. Ridley, and play the man. We shall this day light such a candle by God's grace in England as I trust never shall be put out." Now, when was the last time that you heard a phrase, "play the man," in a very encouraging, motivational, and meaningful way? Not in our current society, because we're not supposed to be men. We're not supposed to like games like football. Frank, that would be shameful for you. How immoral of you. We're supposed to be in touch with our feminine side, and if we turn on the TV, we're constantly barraged with negative TV commercials that denigrate men. One of them was a CarMax commercial. This young father goes out to buy a car for his growing family, and he buys this yellow sports car. And it's funny, but he pulls up into the driveway, smiling ear to ear, and he looks at his wife, and his wife rubs her belly, looks at her daughter, and you know she's thinking, "I love my husband, but he has such a tiny husband brain. Poor guy." So the dejected father goes back to the dealership, turns in his keys, and the damage is done. Men are stupid, men are inferior. And that's par for the course these days. And ironic that a culture that celebrates diversity, that progressives constantly will do everything and anything to destroy manhood in its most obvious and beautiful form. This past September, I read an article from a castrated progressive male from the New York Times called 27 Ways to Be a Modern Man. Here are just two. The modern man has no use for a gun. He doesn't own one, and he never will. The modern man cries. He cries often. Now, the modern man will cry tomorrow if the Broncos lose, but but I'm going to inform you guys how we can play the man, because inside of every one of us is four pillars of masculinity. And I heard this on a podcast a couple years ago. My wife pointed me to it. It's from Stu Weber, and he said this to a group of Christians, and I hope it resonates with you even if you're not a Christian. But the four pillars that exist inside every man are king, warrior, mentor, and friend. And as king, you know, we're not talking about being fanned with a palm branch and being fed grapes, but a king, men are to provide. And if you look back to the story from Adam and Eve, God asked Adam to cultivate, develop, oversee, take charge, and be responsible for the garden. And inside of the men are, we're overseers. So we oversee our homes, businesses, and our families. We are to lead, but we can't lord our kingship over others. So we have this vision to look out for our families and our businesses, or a nation. And this pillar has to be straight. It can't lean one way or the other, because if it does, then everyone suffers. If it leans too far one way, then you have a tyrant, and no one likes a tyrant. Everyone's hurt. The other way, you get a modern New York Times man who does not lead, he does not take ownership, and he never speaks up. The second pillar is of a warrior, and men are to protect. And so this warrior pillar, it's not so much physical strength, but it's a man who has the heart and soul to understand the cause and consequences, and then are willing to give themselves up in defense of that principle. And as a warrior, you can't lean one way or the other. Again, you got to be straight, because if you lean one way, you're a brute. If you lean the other way, you're a coward. So examples of these would be a couple movies came out a couple in the recent 2 or 3 years. Lone Survivor, story of Marcus Luttrell, 13 Hours that came out a couple weeks ago, and also the American Sniper movies. I don't believe these men are bloodthirsty for war, but they just see that they are, that there is a need to protect their families or fellow soldiers, so they're willing to stand between our enemies and us. The third pillar is that of a mentor. Men are supposed to know things. Men are meant to teach. Again, this pillar has to be straight. If it leans one way, you have a know-it-all. Who likes the know-it-all? If you have a leans the other way, you have a dunce. Who likes the dunce? The man who is straight, has a straight pillar in this area, will teach you about life. He teaches you life truth. Two examples I have for you. One, Peter Robinson worked in the Reagan White House, and he wrote a book a couple years ago called How Ronald Reagan Changed My Life. It has nothing to do with politics, nothing to do with policy. It's all about life lessons he learned from Ronald Reagan. Second story is Marcus Luttrell. He comes home from Afghanistan. His life is in shambles. He struggles to adjust to civilian life. He contemplates suicide, and he finds himself at the doorstep of then-Governor Rick Perry's mansion in Texas. Rick Perry brings him in, lets him stay in the governor's mansion, and throughout several years, Perry teaches Marcus Luttrell about life, how to be a good man. And to this day, Marcus Luttrell calls Rick Perry the father that he never had. Finally, and most importantly, that's a good segue to the last pillar, is friend, because men are meant to connect emotionally. How can you be a good king if you can't connect with people within your realm? How can you be a good warrior if you cannot connect with the people you're trying to protect? How can you be a good mentor? How can Rick Perry be a good mentor to Marcus Luttrell if he can't connect with him emotionally? So it's my belief that if men are meant to be men, that our nation, communities, especially our families, will benefit. But it has to start in the home first and foremost. So my call to action is this. Women, can you encourage the king, warrior, mentor, and friend in your life? And men, are you willing to play the man? Thank you.